Welcome back to our channel, or just welcome if you're new here. Today's video is about WordPress caching. It is an essential part of improving your website's performance, so I'll tell you everything there is to know about it. Also, if you're using a caching plugin, let us know in the comments and we'll tell you if it is good. Now, what is caching? It is a process where you store your website's data in a fast access memory, and so you're able to display it faster than if you try to load all over again. For example, when your loyal customer visits your homepage for the second time in an hour, they're accessing the cached version of the page, and that makes it load so much faster. Got it? Now let's see how caching works under the hood. Side note, if you're looking to avoid any technical detail and instead arrive at the optimal caching solution, use a timecode and learn about hosting integrated caching. While the principle of caching is pretty much the same across the board, there are many different techniques to it. Since caching can be done in different stages of a web application, each stage is called a cache layer. There's object caching layer that's enabled in WordPress by default, then there's bytecode cache, page cache, and CDN cache. Let's go through each layer and discuss what it entails. Object caching is extremely common, and in WordPress it is done by default. You see, WordPress database requests are heavy and are cached through object cache. Almost every query is cached by WordPress and the result is reused. The downside here is that it works only for the current request and the cache is not shared between requests. If you use persistent cache storage like Redis or Memcached or APCU, the performance improvement will be much more tangible. I'll put links to all three caching systems in the description down below. Then there's bytecode cache, a good way to accelerate PHP code compilation 3 times. Here's how it works. PHP code compiles into bytecode, which then executes in the PHP engine. The compiling process is slow, but we can speed it up by saving compiled bytecode and reusing it for every request. Here's a diagram for that process. The downside of this cache layer is that if we change our PHP script, we have to clear the bytecode cache. But then we don't change our code in production that often, do we? Plus, there are timers that check for file changes and clear the cache. We won't go into details of installing bytecode on Ubuntu in this video, so if you want, you can click the link in the description and you can follow the instructions in our blog post. The next caching layer is page cache, where you can turn your dynamic WordPress site into a static website. And static sites are, of course, insanely fast. Basically, the idea is to cache the recently generated web page response from PHP FPM as a static HTML file with a specific cache key, like a URL, and serve that file from the cache directory to all the visitors of your website, rather than rerun the PHP scripts and MySQL queries to generate that web page. Can you do this with all sites, all web pages? Of course, no, because if your web page is very dynamic and non-consistent, like let's say it's an eShop, this cache layer won't work. You'll have to configure an exclusion for that page. Okay, so how can you implement Nginx Fast CGI Cache? Just follow the instructions listed in the blog post in the description below. There are too many technical nuances for us to go over here. The final caching layer is CDN cache. But wait, what is CDN? The purpose of CDN is to speed up data travel and improve connectivity. To do this, a CDN locates servers at the exchange points between different networks. These so-called internet exchange points serve as connection spots for different internet providers, allowing them to give each other access to traffic originating from their different networks. By having a connection to these high-speed and highly interconnected locations, a CDN provider is able to reduce costs and transit times in high-speed data delivery. Let's take a look at the scheme. CDN caching is when a CDN caches content in proxy servers located closer to end users than origin servers. The proximity of servers to users who make the request is why a CDN delivers content faster. So when we enable CDN caching, if a client device makes a request for content, it will be served from the nearby server, a cache it. And if CDN doesn't have the copy of the resource to serve and redirects the request to the original server, a cache miss occurs. As a WordPress user, you're probably thinking, okay, but can I just use a plugin for all of this? There seems to be a plugin for everything else. And yep, you're right, there are many caching plugins. Let's go over the 3 most popular ones: WP Rocket, W3 Total Cache, and WP Super Cache. WP Rocket is a pretty popular caching plugin. It promises to drastically improve your site's performance by cleaning up your database, enabling cache preloading, and configuring your CDN. If you go with the $49 single plan, you'll get 1 year of updates and can install the premium plugin on one website. 1 year of updates and 3 websites will cost you $99. The second caching plugin on our list is W3 Total Cache. It has been around for ages and promises to make your website at least 10 times faster. Key features include caching of database objects, pages, posts, feeds, and fragments, browser caching, minification of scripts, and transparent CDN management. The premium version, Total Cache Pro, will cost you $99 per year. Next up, we have WP Super Cache. It offers sort of similar features to W3 Total Cache, but has really simplified its user interface recently. Plus, this solution is more straightforward and perfect for high traffic sites. However, W3 Total Cache is more compatible with all sorts of hosting providers. The good news is, though, that WP Super Cache is completely free. We get it! Site owners and managers have too much on their plate already. They often don't want to know the technical details. If you're one of those people who skipped to this section, no worries, because you can achieve the ultimate high page speed score of 90+ for your website without any manual work. Caching is included in 10web's automatic speed optimization service, so all you need to do is just sign up for the 14-day free trial, create a copy of your site hosted on 10web automatically, and check the performance improvement on both desktop and mobile. Link in the description. Look, this is the old score of a site, and this is the new score. This massive performance boost will not only send your site to the top of Google search, but also boost your conversion rate, according to stats. So guys, this is all. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment the name of your caching plugin, and share this video with other site owners and managers who are struggling to enhance their WordPress site's performance. Take care, and I'll see you in another video.
This video was brought to you by 10web, an automated WordPress platform designed for agencies. Automate hosting, speed optimization, migration, site building and management, and skyrocket your agency growth. Sign up for a 14-day free trial and experience true automation.